Today, I'm going to share a few thoughts with you about cyclone dust separators. Let's get right into it. What do you know about them? We're going to use this to put a force field on the filter. A cyclone dust separator is a way to extend the caking process. What is a good cake? The idea of using one of these with your shop vac is basically a convenience measure so that you don't have to clean the filter that often. Now, how well does it work and how it actually works are both things that I think are worth looking into. So let's have a look. A quick explanation as to how one of these works is that it redirects or detours the dust into the container that it's mounted to, rather than letting that dust go onto the vacuum. So when you think of one of these, it's probably best to think of it as the sum of all of its parts, of which there are three. You have the separator itself, a sturdy airtight container to mount the separator to, and then one additional connection, which is often the perfect place for a short hose. And there it is completed, the separator, the container, and the additional connection. These things do everything they do simply because of the way they're shaped. So what we've got is a steep cone-shaped piece of plastic with three ports. There's a larger discharge port on the bottom and two slightly smaller ports on the top. The horizontal port goes to the tool so the dust comes into the horizontal port, and the vertical port goes to the vacuum cleaner. Now, as the air is being pulled through this thing, inside of this device, a storm is created. It has rotation, it has direction, and most importantly, it has an eye. And this port, the one that the vacuum is connected to, it extends right down into the sweet spot, into the eye of the storm. So as almost all the dust gets caught up in this downward spiraling corkscrew-shaped storm, this thing pulls fresh air from the eye of the same storm. Clearly, you can see that the separator does in fact do what it's supposed to do. And in order to find out how well it works, I'm going to continue running dust through this setup until the caking looks similar to this. And just for good luck. The caking ratio here is roughly 100 to 1. And even though my math is questionable, still, you should be able to tell that a cyclone dust separator does work well. Whoa, what is that? You know, this seems like a good time to mention some of the more negative aspects associated with pairing your shop vac with a dust separator in the first place. Let's face it, adding 3 things to your shop vac is going to make it grow in size, and it's an awkward appendage-like growth. So you've got that. Also, you're likely to get a little bit of a reduction in the suction after you run things through the eye in the storm versus just hooking things up directly to the vacuum. And that kind of sucks. The last thing is just the price of the separators. Even if you buy the Chinese versions, they're a little on the expensive side. Let me show you the 4 different type of separators I have, and we'll wrap this video up. X-Master. Of all the separators I have, these seem to be the ones that work the best. The second and third generation SN50s are also pretty good. The first generation SN50 is the least efficient of the bunch. This one has a flat ceiling, unlike all the other separators that have a descending ceiling, which seems to help force things in the right direction. And because this one is missing that feature, it's a little off. See? It works, it just doesn't work nearly as well as the others. Oh, dude, my God. I'm sorry,
dude,
man.
You poked me in the eye.
I'm so sorry.
Really?
I didn't know you were real.
Really?
Are you real?
What the beep?
Just relax. Try to relax.